हेलो एवरीवन, आज हम पढ़ेंगे क्लास 8 ज्योग्राफी का चैप्टर नंबर 3 मिनरल एंड पावर रिसोर्सेज। इस वीडियो में हम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स को पढ़ेंगे, तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं वीडियो को। एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक सॉल्यूशन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस। नेम एनी 3 कॉमन मिनरल्स यूज्ड बाय योर एवरीडे। आंसर, 3 कॉमन मिनरल्स यूज्ड बाय अस इन डे टू डे लाइफ आर कॉपर, आयरन एंड सॉल्ट। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज एन ओर? वेयर आर द ओर्स ऑफ मेटेलिक मिनरल्स जनरली लोकेटेड? आंसर, ओर इज द रॉ मेटल फाउंड इन द अर्थ मिक्स्ड विद अदर मटेरियल्स और इम्प्योरिटीज। दे आर जनरली लोकेटेड इन इग्नियस और मेटामॉर्फिक रॉक्स। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, नेम टू रीजन्स रिच इन नेचुरल गैस रिसोर्सेज। आंसर, टू रीजन्स इन इंडिया रिच इन नेचुरल गैस रिसोर्सेज आर जैसलमेर एंड कृष्णा गोदावरी डेल्टा। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच सोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी वुड यू सजेस्ट फॉर रूरल एरियाज, कोस्टल एरियाज, एरिड रीजन? आंसर, For rural areas, solar energy and wind energy are feasible option. There are not many high-rise buildings to act as an obstacle for sunlight or to break the momentum of wind. For coastal areas, wind energy and tidal energy are good choice. For arid region, wind energy and solar energy are feasible for reasons similar to rural areas. Next question, give 5 ways in which you can save energy at home. Answer, 5 ways in which one can save energy at home: promoting the use of solar energy as much as possible, using biogas as cooking fuel, drying clothes in sunlight instead of electric dryers to prevent emission and unnecessary use of electricity, avoiding misuse of electricity, switching off fans and lights when not required, using pressure cooker for cooking. Question number 2, take the correct answer. Which one of the following is not a characteristics of minerals? They are inexhaustible. Next, which one of the following is not a producer of mica, Karnataka? Next, which one of the following is a leading producer of copper in the world, Chil? Next, which of these is a non-metallic mineral, limestone? Which continent produces more than half of the world's tin, Asia? Which continent is the leading producer of iron ore in the world, Europe? Which state is a major bauxite producing area, Madhya Pradesh? Next, what is the name given to the electricity produced from coal, thermal power? Next, which of these is a conventional source? All of these: coal, petroleum, natural gas. Which of these is called buried sunshine, coal? Which one of the following practice will not conserve LPG in your kitchen: cooking food in an open pan kept on low flame? Question number 3, give reasons. First, environmental aspects must be carefully looked into before building huge dams. Answer, because of the following reasons, dams created an imbalance in the earth's equilibrium. Deforestation leads to environmental pollution. People are displaced. Cities, villages, towns are shifted, causing untold hardships to people. Flood threats loom large. Earthquake threats, silting of lakes a problem. Next, most industries are concentrated around coal mines. Answer: presence of coal mines around industries reduces the cost of transportation and also ensures easy availability of fuel. Next, petroleum is referred to as black gold. Answer: petroleum is a black, very valuable fossil fuel. It is used for running all types of machinery, transport vehicles, from a bicycle to an aeroplane. Next, quarrying can become a major environmental concern. Answer: after quarrying, pits are not covered, so they may cause environmental hazards. Next, fill in the blanks. Metallic minerals are classified into ferrous and non-ferrous. Gold and silver are non-ferrous minerals. Minerals can be extracted by mining, drilling, and quarrying. Deep bores dug to reach mineral deposits are called shafts. Metallic minerals are generally found in igneous and metamorphic rock formations. The mineral deposits in North America have located in three zones: the Canadian region north of the Great Lakes, the Appalachian region, and the mountain range of the West. Australia is the largest producer of bauxite in the world. Coal is the most abundantly available fossil fuel. Petroleum is drilled from oil fields. Bhakra Nangal is an important hydel power station in India. Uranium and thorium are radioactive metals. Next, state whether each of the following statements is true or false. First, all ores are rocks, but all rocks are not minerals. True. Next, quarrying is good for the environment. False. Next, mineral fuels like coal and petroleum are found in sedimentary strata. True. Next, coal is more predominant in the Canadian Shield region than the Appalachian. False. Chile and Peru are leading producer of copper. True. Kolar in Karnataka has large deposits of silver. False. Copper is an element used in almost everything. True. Bauxite is the ore of aluminium. True. Nuclear power can be produced from the nuclei of most elements. False. Very short answers. Question number 1. Differentiate between a rock and an ore. Answer: a rock is an aggregate of one or more minerals. An ore is a rock from which minerals are mined. Next question. Define quarrying. Answer: quarrying is a process of extraction in which minerals lying near the surface are simply dug out. Next question. Name the leading tin producers in Asia. Answer: China, Malaysia, and Indonesia are leading tin producers in Asia. Next question. Name two areas in Australia which have large deposits of gold. Answer: two areas in Western Australia having large deposits of gold are Kalgoorlie and Coolgardie. Next, name two minerals in whose production India contributes a significant part. Answer: India has vast deposits of high-grade iron ore and it is also a leading producer of salt. Next, in which industry is silicon important? From which ore is it obtained? Answer: silicon is important in the computer industry. It is obtained from quartz. Next, why are minerals considered non-renewable? Answer: Minerals take thousands of years to form. The rate of formation is much smaller than the rate of consumption, so we classify them as non-renewable. Next, why is coal called Viride Sunshine? Answer: coal is called Viride Sunshine because it is found viride under the earth and is as important a source of energy as sunshine. Next, why are petroleum and its derivatives called black gold? Answer: petroleum and its derivatives are black in color but as valuable as gold, so we refer to it as black gold. Next question: what is natural gas? Answer: natural gas is a fossil fuel obtained with petroleum deposits in oil fields. Next question: which was the first country to develop hydroelectricity? Answer: Norway was the first country to develop hydroelectricity. Next question: name some important hydel power stations in India. Answer: Bhakra Nangal, Gandhi Sagar, Nagarjuna Sagar and Damodar Valley projects are important hydel power stations in India. Next question: name nuclear power stations in India. Answer: Kalpakkam, Tarapur, Rana Pratap Sagar, Narora and Kaiga are the nuclear power stations in India. Next question: give one advantage of biogas over natural gas. Answer: biogas is a renewable source of energy, whereas the amount of natural gas is limited. Next question: what is a mineral? Answer: a naturally occurring substance that has a definite chemical composition is a mineral. Next question: what is meant by a rock? Answer: rock is an aggregate of one or more minerals but without definite composition of constituent of mineral. Next question: define open cast mining. Answer: minerals that lie at shallow depth are taken out by removing the surface layer. This is known as open cast mining. Next question: what does the term quarrying mean? Answer: minerals that lie near the surface are simply dug out by the process known as quarrying. Next question: which country has no known mineral deposits in it? Answer: Switzerland has no known mineral deposits in it. Next question: name the two countries of Asia that have large iron ore deposits. Answer: China and India have large iron ore deposits. Next question: how is salt obtained? Answer: salt is obtained from seas, lakes and rocks. Next question: where are the oldest rocks in world located in? Answer: the oldest rocks in the world are in Western Australia. Next question: define geothermal energy. Answer: heat energy obtained from the earth is called geothermal energy. Next question: what is biogas? Answer: organic waste such as dead plant and animal material and dung and kitchen waste can be converted into gaseous fuel called biogas. Next question: name the greatest producer of nuclear power. Answer: USA and Europe. Next question: which type of energy is wind energy? Answer: wind is an inexhaustible source of energy. Next question: how are windmills used since times immerial. Answer: windmills have been used for grinding grain and lifting water since times immemorial. Next question: define geothermal energy. Answer: heat energy obtained from earth. Next question: in which part of India there is a huge tidal mill farms? Answer: in the Gulf of Kutch. Next question: where in India are the geothermal plants located? Answer: Manikaran in Himachal Pradesh and Puga Valley in Ladakh. Next question: how is firewood widely used? Answer: it is widely used for cooking and heating. Next question: what are the two main conventional sources of energy? Answer: firewoods and fossil fuels. Next question: which is the most abundantly found fossil fuel? Answer: coal is the most abundantly found fossil fuel. Next question: what is the thermal power? Answer: electricity from coal is called thermal power. Short answers. Question number 1: name and describe briefly methods of extraction. Answer: mining, drilling and quarrying are methods of extraction. Mining is a process of extraction of taking out minerals from rocks under the earth's surface. Open cast mining: in this, minerals lying at shallow depth are taken out by removing the surface layer. Shaft mining: in this, deep pores called shafts are made to reach mineral deposits lying at large depth. Drilling: in this, deep wells are bored to take out minerals. Quarrying: it is the process of extraction in which minerals lying very close to the surface are extracted just by digging them out. Next question: where are minerals found? Answer: minerals are found in different types of rocks. Metallic minerals are usually found in igneous and metamorphic rocks that form large plateaus. Examples: iron ore is found in North Sweden, copper and nickel in Canada. In igneous and metamorphic rocks in South Africa, iron, nickel, chromites and platinum are found. Non-metallic minerals are found in sedimentary rocks formation. Limestone deposits are found in France. Mineral fuels such as coal and petroleum are found in sedimentary strata. Next question: describe the mineral distribution in North America. Answer: the mineral deposits in North America are found in three zones: the Canadian region in the north of the Great Lakes, the Appalachian region and the Rocky Mountains in the west. Iron ore, nickel, gold, uranium and copper are mined in the Canadian Shield region. Coal in the Appalachian region. Western Cordilleras have vast deposits of copper, lead, zinc, gold and silver. Next question: write common uses of minerals. Answer: minerals are important in many industries. Minerals used in gems are usually very hard. These are then set in varying styles of jewelry. Iron and copper are metals used in almost everything. Copper is present in everything from coins to pipes and electricity wires. Silicon, obtained from the mineral quartz, is the base of the computer industry. Aluminium, obtained from bauxite ore and its alloys, are used in aeroplanes due to their lightweight. Aluminium is also used in kitchen cookware. Next question: how is hydroelectricity produced? Answer: hydroelectricity is produced from the energy processed by water falling from great heights. River water is stored in dams. When rainwater or river water falls from heights, it flows over turbine blades placed at the bottom of the dam. The moving blades are connected to a generator which produces electricity from this energy. This electricity is called hydroelectricity. The water discharged after its production is used for irrigation. Next question. Give a brief note on mining. Answer. The process of taking out minerals from rocks buried under the earth's surface is called mining. Mining can be classified into open cast mining and shaft mining. Open cast mining refers to a method of extracting rock or mineral from the earth by their removal from an open pit or burrow. Open pit mines are used when deposits of commercially useful minerals or rocks are found near the surface. Shaft mining refers to the method of sinking a vertical or near vertical tunnel from the top down, where there is initially no access to the bottom. The shaft have to be made to reach mineral deposits that lie at great depth. Next question. How is the distribution of iron placed in India? Answer. India has deposits of high-grade iron ore. The mineral is found mainly in Jharkhand, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Goa, Maharashtra, and Karnataka. Next question. Name the major limestone-producing states in India. Answer. Major limestone-producing states in India are Bihar, Jharkhand, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Tamil Nadu. Next question. What is coal and why is coal referred to as buried sunshine? Answer. Coal is most evidently found fossil fuel. It is used as domestic fuel in industries such as iron and steel, steam engines, and to generate electricity. Electricity from coal is called thermal power. The coal which we are using today was formed millions of years ago when giant ferns and swamps got buried under the layer of earth. Coal is therefore referred to as buried sunshine. Next question. Define tidal energy and where was the first tidal energy station built? Answer. Energy generated from tides is called tidal energy. Tidal energy can be harnessed by building dams at narrow opening of the sea. During high tide, the energy of the tides is used to turn the turbine installed in the dam to produce electricity. Russia, France, and Gulf of Kutch in India have used tidal mill farms. The first tidal energy station was built in France. Next question. How is petroleum found and what is petroleum and its derivatives known as and why? Answer. Petroleum is found between the layers of rocks and is derivative derived from oil field located in offshore and coastal areas. Then this is sent to refinery which process the crude oil and produce a variety of products. Petroleum and its derivatives are called black gold because they are valuable. Long answers. Question number 1. Name and describe some non-conventional sources of energy. Answer. Non-conventional power sources are those power sources that have come into use recently due to the depleting conventional resources and growing awareness. सोलर एनर्जी, विंड एनर्जी, जियोथर्मल एनर्जी, न्यूक्लियर पावर एंड टाइडल एनर्जी आर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ नॉन कन्वेंशनल पावर सोर्सेस। सोलर एनर्जी इज द हीट एंड लाइट एनर्जी कैप्चर्ड फ्रॉम द सन। सोलर सेल्स हेल्प टू कन्वर्ट दिस एनर्जी टू इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। सोलर एनर्जी इज यूज्ड इन सोलर हीटर्स, सोलर कुकर्स, सोलर ड्रायर्स एटसेट्रा। विंड एनर्जी इज द एनर्जी possessed by moving air, wind. Windmills are used to convert wind energy to the electricity. Wind farms having clusters of windmills located in coastal regions and mountain passes. Nuclear power is the energy possessed by the nuclei of the atoms of naturally occurring radioactive elements like uranium, thorium, etc. Geothermal energy is the heat energy obtained from the inside of the earth. The temperature inside the earth increases as we go deeper. This heat is used to produce electricity. It is accessed in the form of hot springs. Tidal energy is the energy generated from tides. It is harnessed by building dams at narrow opening of the sea. Biogas is a gaseous fuel obtained from the decomposition of organic waste like dead plant and animal material or animal dung and kitchen waste. It is an excellent fuel for cooking and lighting and is environment friendly. Next question. Write the advantages and disadvantages of non-conventional sources of energy. Answer: Advantages. Non-conventional sources of energy are usually inexhaustible. They do not pollute the environment. Nuclear power is emitted in large amounts. Most non-conventional sources of energy cost less. These forms of energy are safe to use and clean. Disadvantages. Windmills are costly to set up, so using them to harness wind energy is costly, even though the electricity generated from it is cheap. Setting up windmills disrupts radio and TV broadcast. Harnessing tidal energy destroys the natural habitats of wildlife. Moreover, tidal energy is difficult to harness. Obtaining nuclear energy from radioactive materials generates radioactive waste. It is expensive too. Biogas, although useful and renewable, contributes to the greenhouse effect. Next question. Write a brief note on salt. Answer. Salt is a dietary mineral essential for animal life. It is composed primarily of sodium chloride. Salt is produced in different forms. They are unrefined salt or sea salt, refined salt or table salt, and iodized salt. Salt is a crystalline solid, white, pale pink or light gray in color. It is obtained by evaporation of seawater, usually in shallow basin warmed by sunlight. It is also obtained from rock deposits. Salt is used in more than 14,000 commercial applications other than in cooking. It is used in the manufacture of pulp and paper, setting dyes in textile and fabric. It is also used in producing soaps and detergents and for making snow-covered roads safe in winter. Salt plays an essential role in our daily lives. Next question. Define mineral in brief and explain how they are formed without any human interference. Answer. A naturally occurring substance that has a definite chemical composition in a mineral. Minerals are not evenly distributed over space, they are concentrated in a particular area or rock formations. Some minerals are found in areas which are not easily accessible, such as the Arctic Ocean bed and Antarctica. Minerals are formed in different types of geological environments. Under varying conditions, they are created by natural processes without any human interference. They can be identified on the basis of their physical properties, such as color, density, hardness, and chemical properties, such as solubility. Next question: what is meant by nuclear power? Explain the process, how it is obtained. Also name the places of India where the nuclear power stations are located. Answer: nuclear power is obtained from energy stored in the nuclei of atoms of naturally occurring radioactive elements like uranium and thorium. These fuels undergo nuclear fission in nuclear reactors and emit power. The greatest producers of nuclear power are USA and Europe. In India, Rajasthan and Jharkhand have large deposits of uranium. Thorium is found in large quantities in the monazite sands of Kerala. The nuclear power stations in India are located in Kalpakkam in Tamil Nadu, Tarapur in Maharashtra, Rana Pratap Sagar near Kota in Rajasthan, Narora in UP, एंड कायगा इन कर्नाटका. इसी के साथ ही हमारा ये वीडियो कंप्लीट होता है. इस चैप्टर के वीडियो एक्सप्लेनेशन के लिए आप डिस्क्रिप्शन में दिए गए लिंक को क्लिक करके देख सकते हैं. आपको ये वीडियो कैसा लगा हमें कमेंट करके ज़रूर बताएं. साथ ही हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें, बेल आइकन को दबाना ना भूलें, जिससे आपके पास हमारी लेटेस्ट अपडेट पहुँचती रहे. धन्यवाद.